Hello, UPSC Success Community members. I hope you are doing wonderful. You are 10 times excited. So let me share some of the productivity tips which will help you increase your productivity. So if you are dealing with a lot of distractions, not able to accomplish the task, feeling very, very difficulty in achieving your targets, you must stay here. So let's see what are we going to discuss here. We will discuss some of the tips and tricks for pre-planning your tasks, managing things in the journey of your preparation, how to manage the sudden interruptions, and then you should post the comment about what action you are going to take. So let's start. Pre-planning, this is the important aspect. If you pre-plan, it actually keeps you focused. So first of all, you should challenge yourself. If you think that you can cover a particular chapter of history in 1 hour, then you should target 50 minutes. That will keep you on your toes and that will keep you away from the distractions. Remember, the Parkinson's law always says that you should challenge yourself. So do this ongoingly. Number two, remove unnecessary clutters from your life. The digital clutters, the physical clutters, and the mental clutters. Digital can be in the form of useless videos, useless reels, shorts, stories from Facebook, Instagram, YouTube. Physical distractions can be unclean table, disturbed room, outside noise coming into your room, or dirty clothes you are wearing. These small things matter a lot. Mental clutter, maybe disempowering conversations about yourself, your fears, undelivered communication which are holding you back. So think about it and take action. Gathering the resources. Suppose tomorrow you have to prepare for the CSAT. So the day before, you should gather all the resources. What all material are you going to start with? Which books, which test paper you are going to practice? What if you are not able to solve some question, will you access to some teacher, or will you email someone, or you will write the query? You should always think in advance, what are you going to do and how are you going to manage the resources? Create a productive hour. This is very important, right? And for you, I will recommend at least 8 productive hours, not 16, not 4, 8 is a very good number. Use calendar reminders. For example, if you are using 3 productive hours in the morning, say 6 a.m. to 9 a.m., you should put an alarm that, okay, 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. is for prelims, current affairs, or solving the MCQs. Number two, second block, suppose it is from 12 to 3 p.m. If this is for answering practice or optional. Third block, for example, it is from 6 p.m. to 9 p.m. This is from this time to this time. So it will help you make consistent. Use the same calendar, same timing for the same subject consistently for 7 days. This will make your mind habitual and you don't have to remind your mind that where to focus upon. Your mind will be automatically working upon the right things. Clearly define the borders. Many a time when some loved one calls me, maybe mother, father, boyfriend, girlfriend, any colleague, I get distracted. But if I'm doing something really important, at least I can communicate it to my near and dear ones. I can tell, okay, I'm not available from 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. And if it is really important, then only you should call me. Otherwise, I'm available between 9 a.m. to 10 a.m. or 9 a.m. to 11 a.m., right? And you should also communicate the importance so that they also get enrolled into your possibility. So you should tell them, if you really want me to become the IAS officer, please support me. And also your commitment that, my sister or mother or anyone, just tell them that I have taken 1 year off from the job and I really want to continue focusing upon my journey. So I need your support. I need your help, right? Next thing is managing things in the journey of your life. there are many things which you need to manage. First of all, prepare your mind. Subconscious mind is something which you need to work upon. So you should always do the visualization exercises. Always, you know, visualize yourself being a productive student. Think positive about yourself. And if you really work on your mind, maybe through meditation, it gives you very good insights. It keeps you close to the nature. It gives you peace and really it helps you be more productive. 90 minute block. This is something which you should follow. I have shared the technique of Pomodoro in my UPSC Toppers Club workshop. I hope you have attended that. This Pomodoro cycle, this should be 25 minute plus 5 minute, or you can also you make it 50 minute plus 10 minute. So this will give you consistent energy. It will make your mind habitual for focusing for 25 minutes and taking a break of 5 minutes. Then remove the distractions, especially the digital distractions, the notifications, unnecessary apps. Always, remove the notifications from your apps and from your unnecessary things. So you can just hear the notification in my mobile phone. This is the distraction that I was talking about. And this was a intentional distraction, which actually distracted my video. Can you see? This is the power of distraction. So you should silent, you should remove the notification. Maybe you can go off and you can use the airplane mode. Okay. Break time is very, very important. Right. If you really want to become the marathoner in your preparation, use the break time. Never be guilty about it. And there is a simple logic. If you are reading for 25 minutes, take a break of 5 minutes. Keep in the ratio of 5:1 or 4:1. If you are reading for 20 minutes, take a break of 10 minutes. Sorry, 5 minutes. Okay. And try to have these breaks, non-screen breaks, rather than screen breaks. If you have the non-screen breaks, it gives you refreshment. It does not take away your energy. And always take 3 big deep breaths. It removes all your stress and it makes you keep, you know, it makes you natural and it makes you composed. Okay, so just take 3 big deep breaths like this. So if you did not practice with me, then pause this video and first practice. And then you should see the rest of the video. Every night before sleep, visualize the work as it is finished, right? So suppose you are visualizing tomorrow, you will be completing the current affairs till June 2021 or August 2021. Think in advance. It will give you much desired energy, right? So recently, Mr. Neeraj Chopra, who won the gold medal in the Olympics, he also emphasizes that visualization really helps. So use this technique. Interruptions. Mostly these are distractions, right? Sudden interruptions. So maybe you want to take a tea, or maybe you want to speak to someone, or maybe you just want to go out and look here and there, or maybe you just want to have a nap. All these are, you know, instant gratification things which your mind, body, or your habitual pattern is looking for. But before doing something like this, hold for a minute. Just be self-aware. What is happening? How your body is reacting to it? Why are you being so much, impatient about it? And think that, is it really important than the current work? If no, then continue the current work. And you have successfully managed your distraction. 99% you'll find this distraction was really useless. And 1% time, if you still find that this distraction is really productive, so you should schedule it, you should postpone, and maybe you should write in your diary that, okay, I will do this task at this point of time. This will ensure that you did not miss out on that task. I hope you learned something. So I will request, please post in the comment section What actions are you taking on from this video and how this is going to help you? Share this video with your friends, and I wish all the best. With this, I finish and I am completing this video.